And the next match on court is the women's doubles. Here come the Malaysian pair of Vivian Hu and Woon Ki-wei, taking on Tang Jin-hwa and Zhong Xin-jian. Tang Jin-hwa and Zhong Xin-jian. Fairly new partnership. Up against a more established pair in terms of the Malaysians.
Red, blue.
Woon.
The umpire. Sri Lanka.
Who received?
Tang.
On the toss of the coin. Zhong Xin. Tang Jin-hwa. Up against Vivian Hu and Woon Ki-wei then. A partnership that started this year up against another. Got together first back in 2010. Should be a fairly even affair, really. The other semi-finalists involve the in-form Bao Yixin and Tang Yuan Ting. Of course, won two out of two events. The All England Swiss Open, they'd be the favourites, of course. Chen Qingchen and Jia Yifin, who are the young guns, the 17-year-olds. But more mature players on court here. Zhong, 24, Tang, 23. Vivian Hu is 25 and Woon is 26. There is Vivian Hu, which the quarterfinals of the Malaysian Open recently. Into the semi-finals. Straightforward yesterday, came through against the Japanese pair of Higashino and Chizato Hoshi. We'll be seeing shortly in the women's singles in just 33 minutes, but way over an hour on court, having to turn things around from a gay down against the Chinese pair of Du and Li. Tang Jin-hwa. Tianxin. They got through in straight games throughout, so they've been mightily impressive. Looking at the number four seeds of Chen and Lei yesterday from Chinese Taipei. Doubles semi-final to get underway.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Tang Jin-hwa, Zhong Xin-jian, China. And on my left, Vivian Tang Wu, Taiwan, Woon, Malaysia. Taiwan want to serve to Tang Jin-hwa, Lawan, play.
Well, their first meeting, of course, the Chinese pair have only been together a few events. Into the net from Zhong there. confident start from the Commonwealth Games gold medalists of Vivian Hu and Kiwei. Tang Jinhua won this title with Wan Xie back in 2011. Some successful partnerships, obviously, with Ma Jin, even better one with Bao Yixin, won five big events in the other part of 2013, three Super Series events at the start of 2014. They were the women's doubles number one pair. Tang Jinhua and Bao Yixin, of course, Bao now. The women's final alongside Tang Jinhua. And now after a flyer together as well, aren't they? Doubles pair looking to end a title drought that goes back to the Indonesia Open Grand Prix gold event in 2011. So it's been a long time coming. side from Zhong. Well, say just wide, a long way wide from Zhong. An even contest so far, this women's doubles affair. Herself there. Eight. Flick serve from Vivian Hu. This time, but again, that was a long way wide. That's it. So it's Vivian Hu and Woon Ki Wei who have a very slender advantage at the interval, 11 points to 10. Now. That's a bit unfair. It's nice to see Vivian Hu and Woon Ki Wei haven't won a title since 2011 when they did win Commonwealth Games gold, but obviously it's participation's limited. Peter Shwala Kwanapar and Shwala Gutta of India in that final in Glasgow last August. They won the Southeast Asian Games gold as well. Bronze medalists at the Asian Games. So they've got pedigree, haven't they? Good test this for Tang and Zhong. The interval, no one's won 2 points in a row. You have a point, we'll have a point. Determination from Jinsing there.
I was going to let that one go.
Good to see her fired up as well. Continues. 11-10. Who and Woon at the interval. It's been a point for each duo ever since. On the other serve, and it's 15-14. Just came off the net. That was enough to put Vivian Hu off. Put it long, back to 15-all. Flick serve this time. Oh, I was going to say, a real chance to for someone to win a point on their serve, but Zhong completely mistimed that one. Bell is broken. Oh, it's kind of a hopeful lift, wasn't it, by Woon? But it landed right on the line. And that's long. And suddenly, 3 points in a row. And the Malaysian pair have kind of sprinted towards 3 points away from the opening game.
Ah!
back the cup.
17, 18.
Good aggressive play, isn't it? Tug at the back of the court and then the smash from Zhong. Much tape, it's bandages on the player's legs. Big knee one for Zhong. Jizmaya's got it pasted all down her leg. Still the Malaysian twosome with an advantage here though, albeit just the 1 point. Well, a nice run of points from 18-15 down. They've got a game point here, Tang Jianhua and Zhong Jiansin. What a clash of rackets. The wrong moment for the Chinese pair. Game point saved, 20 all. Pairs turn for a game point.
21, 20.
Quick to get there, take the opportunity. Game point, Malaysia. Put away by Zhong. 22-21, the Chinese pair leading here in this opening game. Game point number two for Zhong here. Not looking great for them, 18-15 down. But Tang Jinhua and Zhong Jiansin able to take the second game point that came their way. Good aggressive badminton from the fairly new put together Chinese pair. And they take the opening game by 23 points to 21. Huge disappointment, obviously, at the end of that game. At a game point of their own, Vivian Hu and Woon Ki Wei. Now they got to pick themselves up against what was towards that end of that game, a very buoyant Tang and Zhong. They looked very good, especially when they got more aggressive there towards the end of that game. You'd expect the second game to be tied again. Isn't there at the Chinese pair right now? Five in the corner. But they certainly are making the Malaysians move about, aren't they? Vivian Hu running around at the back of the court. Another one netted. Similar pattern following, isn't it, from game number one? Tang. And wide from Zhong. Missed chance that for the Chinese to edge ahead here. Doing a lot of things right. A little bit at the moment, the Malaysian pair. I know it's only 1 point in the game, but I feel like it's a big stage of the second game that has been dominated by the Chinese pair. To get themselves out of this little, what call it, slump, but lethargy. Pretty well there at the net, and Woon. But how about that for a winner from Zhong? Dead weighting it perfectly. Pattern established again. 7 points all. There was nothing between them in the first game, nothing between them in the second. A terrific angle from Woon there. They're heavy in this game. Such aggression in the game. Women's double semi-final. Tight first game. More of the same so far in the second.
Nine, eight.
working hard for the advantage here. But an advantage they do have, Tang Jinhua and Zhong Jixian. Excellent rally. The Malaysians kept that alive fantastically. Some wonderful shots all round, really. And then the winner from Zhong at the interval, and I wonder whether that proves to be the point that takes them on their way to victory here. That was a wonderful rally. They won that point a couple of times, really. Credit to Woon and Hu here for keeping it alive as long as they did. But after taking the opening game, Zhong, Jianxin and Tang Jinhua have 11-8 interval lead in the second. Back, isn't it, for Vivian Hu and Wu Kiwei now. The new coach starting at the beginning of next month, Lim Peck-Sia. He's obviously under Rosman. He's at the last couple of years. New coach coming their way. Quite a spectacular as the one before, but both points going the way of the Chinese pair. For Woon, nice disguise, played it into the open court, put it just wide, agonizing. And now it's a 6-point lead, and 7 points in a row from the Chinese pair. It's been a charge to the finishing line, really. A game that is, I should say, a match that's been so tight throughout, suddenly 8 points in a row, and it's a case of see you later. There's one back. Great net play from Tang. Well, you have to to give them credit, I mean, obviously, Vivian, Hu and Woon Ki Wei here are deflated, they're dispirited, but this has been excellent badminton to take this match by the grass that the Chinese pair have done. Vivian Hu this time, it's turning into this kind of game. 8-7 up they were. They're now 17-9, no, rather 18-9 down. Well, it looked like it would be a tight affair, but it's become rather uncomplicated, hasn't it? Tang Jinhua and Zhong Jianxin here, stretching away. 10-point lead. Well, I wasn't expecting match points to come this quickly. Just been blown away here, Vivian Hu and Woon Ki Wei. Seven match points. And you need one of them though. How about that? Bing, bang, bosh. Over as quick as a flash in the end. 38 minutes when this looked like being a long match. What a storming finish to the end. They won 13 of the last 14 points there. And into the final. Go Tang Jinhua and Zhong Jianxin. 23-21, 21-9. A really excellent performance from the Chinese women doubles pair. And now it's time for women's singles. Singles is we've seen all the seeds knocked out. The two names maybe weren't supposed to see, and I suppose you have to put Chisato Hoshi in that character, the Japanese player here facing Sui Hui. It's the young guns who have dominated the women's singles. Michelle Lee, the number one seed, did turn up, but the rest have been sent packing. These two players know that He Bing Zhao, the 18-year-old, the Asian junior champion, who came through pretty comfortably earlier on this afternoon, beating Chen Yufei, who's only 17 years old, at 21-13, 21-10 in just 36 minutes on the other court. So a chance for this young lady here to try and make it in an all-Chinese affair in the women's singles. We've seen won this event the past couple of years, but not here to defend. And it's Zui Hui up against Chisato Hoshi. Chisato Hoshi there, 18-year-old from Japan. Not played a singles event since last April. And we could say Zui Hui, she's not played really that much in the last year as well. The only international event of 2015, the China International Challenge, where she reached the quarterfinals. And a nice passage for the Chinese youngster to this stage as well. Just 29 minutes on court so far. She got a bye in round one, then she got a walkover in round two. As I mentioned, Michelle, the number one seed, didn't come in. Yesterday, she beat Gao Fangji, her compatriot, 21-10, 21-14. So it doesn't come much easier than that, does it? As for Chisato Hoshi, well, also played in the women's doubles, but she came through against Fan Mingyang yesterday in straight games.
Ladies and gentlemen.
And she also came through against Supanida Kitatong of Thailand in straight games too. Ulonggu is our umpire. Huan Zheng, our service judge.
Hui Xilei to serve. Level play.
So, you know, the women's singles final will be contested by He Bing Zhao. Will it be Chisato Hoshi or Zui Hui, who she'll face in tomorrow's chase for gold? Very nice start. Well, you have to say that Chisato Hoshi is a surprise candidate in the semi-finals. I mean, her world ranking means nothing, 623 in the world. Last April, she played her last singles event. She reached the second event round of the Osaka International Challenge. That was, of course, in Japan. The event before that, she did reach the final. That was at the Polish International. She was playing women's doubles here with Arisa Higashino in the women's doubles they lost yesterday. I have to say, it's been a rather nervous start.